Everyone, again, this is the view of Jupiter Saturn, but we're at UCF and we're under some patchy clouds, so the view comes in and out now and then. We'll get back to the view as soon as the clouds allow. Oh, here it looks like Saturn's popping out again. A little bit. Hi everyone, thanks for joining us again. We're watching the Jupiter-Saturn conjunction from UCF. It's a little bit of patchy cloud, so the view comes in and out. Right now it's pretty good. You see Jupiter in the upper left and Saturn in the lower right. You may notice that I have to, the planets appear to make a kind of jerky movements every once in a while. It's just me adjusting the telescope a little bit so that the view stays well centered. This is, we're looking at a very tiny patch of sky. So if you were to think about the size of the moon in the sky, the distance between Jupiter and Saturn right now is just about 20% of the diameter of the full moon. If you're outside at all, you can see the full, you can see the quarter moon right now. Think about the diameter of the quarter moon or diameter of the moon. The distance between Jupiter and Saturn is just about 20% of that diameter of the moon. So it's a very tiny patch of sky. Consequently, we need to adjust our telescope a little bit every now and then to make sure that it stays pointed right on the two planets. And again, this is the best, this is the closest these planets will be, or they have been, closest the planets have been for almost 400 years. The next time they'll be this close, it'll be 2080. Great. Hi, everyone. Again, we're looking at the view through the telescope of the Jupiter-Saturn conjunction, the best conjunction in almost 400 years. We're having a good view right now of Jupiter in the upper left and Saturn in the lower right. You can see the rings of Saturn very clearly, and you can kind of make out a little bit of the stripes on the atmosphere of Jupiter in the upper left. Again, this is the closest they'll have been in almost 400 years. We're getting patchy clouds coming in and out. So if the view drops out every once in a while, it's because the clouds are passing through, but we're trying to keep the view on the planets as much as possible. Thanks. Right, hi everybody, thanks for watching. We're still on Jupiter and Saturn. As you can see, the view is getting a little more scraggly. We still have clouds coming in and out. We're gonna try to keep the telescope on the view of the planets as long as possible. The clouds keep coming in and out. But again, you can kind of see Jupiter in the upper left, Saturn in the lower right. You can kind of see sometimes the planets seem to jerk quickly. That's because I'm adjusting the telescope a little bit to make sure that the view stays on the planets. So, the planets are getting kind of low in the sky now. We're watching them low in the southwest. That's why the image quality is getting a little bit worse too. But you can still see the rings of Saturn. You can still see some of the features on Jupiter's atmosphere. Again, this is the closest these planets have come in almost 400 years. To give you some sense of scale, if you were looking at the moon's out right now. If you think about how big the diameter of the moon is, this distance between, or the gap in between Jupiter and Saturn right now is only about 20% of the diameter of the moon. It's a very tiny gap. Hi, everyone. Thanks for watching. We're still on Jupiter and Saturn. As you can see, the view is getting a little bit more scraggly because we're pointing very low in the southwest, and there seems to be a bunch of clouds in that direction, so the view is a little bit fainter than we expected. But still, it's the closest that Jupiter and Saturn have been for almost 400 years. The next time they'll be this close will be 2080. So this is definitely a very rare event that we're getting to watch here. Hi, everyone. Thanks for watching. We're still on Jupiter and Saturn. The view is getting a little rough right now because we're looking very low to the sky, very low to the horizon. And it's Florida. There's a lot of clouds. What do you know? But the planet in the upper left is Jupiter. The planet in the lower right is Saturn. It looks a little smudgy, but that's Saturn. You can kind of tell the rings are there. This is the closest these two planets will be, or the closest these planets have been in almost 400 years. Hi, everyone. Thanks for keeping watching. This is the closest Jupiter-Saturn conjunction in almost 400 years. The view's a little bit better now. The clouds have been coming in and out. We're also pointing very low to the southwest, and we're also looking over a bunch of turbulent air over Orlando from our view from UCF. But you can see upper left is Jupiter, lower right is Saturn. You can definitely see the rings of Saturn. They're nice and clearly right now. Everyone, we're continuing to watch Jupiter and Saturn. It's gotten a little bit better in the last minute or so. The view of Jupiter and Saturn, the closest they've been in almost 400 years. Jupiter is on the upper left, Saturn's on the lower right. We're looking very low in the southwest sky through hazy, turbulent air. That's why it looks a little bit blurry. We can definitely see the rings of Saturn quite easily. Just to give you a sense of the scale here, if you think about how big the diameter of the full moon is, or the diameter of the moon, you can go outside and look at the moon right now. The diameter of the moon is about half a degree. The separation here between Jupiter and Saturn is about 20, just 20% of that. So it's much tinier compared to the size of angular size of the moon. The other thing is that Saturn is about twice as far away from us as Jupiter is. So even though the planets look like they're almost next to each other in the sky, Saturn is actually several hundred millions of miles farther away. It's also about 10 times fainter than Jupiter is. Everyone, we finally managed to get a little bit of a view of Jupiter's moons. Those dots to the side of Jupiter, those are two of Jupiter's Galilean satellites. You can see we have to pump up the exposure time on the camera so high that Jupiter and Saturn themselves are washed out. But you can at least see that you've got a view of Jupiter's moons as well as Jupiter and Saturn. Everyone, as you can see, the image quality is not quite as good. The planets are quite bright. The clouds have finally moved away, but the planets are getting a little bit rough looking here because we're looking very low to the southwest, and soon they're going to be falling behind a building from our vantage point on UCF. We won't have them for much longer. But again, this is, you're getting to see the planet almost 400 years. years from now, hopefully some of us will still be around to see that maybe. Anyway, the view is, like I said, the view is getting a little red. My computer is freaking out. Well, when you're sharing your screen and random things happen, pop up on your Windows desktop. There we go. Anyway, the view is getting pretty raggy because we're about to lose the planets behind the roof of a building, but we'll stay on them as long as we can. Hi everyone. So the planets just went behind a building from where we are. So we'll move the telescope to the moon just to finish it off, and then we'll stop the stream. But it was just a second, and we'll get the view of the moon to finish off. Hi, everybody. So I got the telescope pointed on the moon. This is the equivalent of it, just to give you maybe a sense of scale for what the camera that we were just using to look at the planets was like. Here's a view of the moon. You can see you don't get the whole moon in the view. That, like I was saying before, the view of Jupiter and Saturn was pretty zoomed in. You can just kind of move around and see different parts of the moon.
I want science. Check out them craters.
So we got a nice view. There we go. Am I muted? No, I'm not muted. Okay. All right. Got a nice view. You can see, get really good views. Hopefully someday we'll get back to doing these events in person. You can come to Robinson Observatory and we have the telescope set up and you can see this stuff with your own eyes instead of just looking at it through a computer screen. So thanks everybody for signing on to this. I hope you got a good view of some planets and hopefully we'll see you actually in person maybe in 2021 if we're lucky. And you can always pay attention to our website and you can pay attention to our social media accounts also to, we'll put announcements about our events up. Hopefully we'll have something for you all to do in 2021, all right? So again, thanks everybody for signing on. Really appreciate it. And take care. We'll see you next time.